While we were sinners, Jesus died for us. No more shame, no more fear. Our Savior is alive forever. God is near. Christ the Lord is risen today. The Lamb of God has taken our sins away. Love's redeeming work is done. Raise your voice, the King has overcome. Hallelujah, hallelujah. By His grace, long ago, our sins were as scarlet, now they're white as snow. Love was nailed to the cross. His dying and His rising has changed our hearts. Christ the Lord is
this morning as we celebrate this Resurrection Day, and we're grateful that you're here. And just want to let you know, if there are any guests with us this morning, we have a welcome gift bag we'd like to give you. So after the service there, if you want to grab one of those, that would be great. We're so glad you're here, and if you could also fill out a welcome card. We also want to let you know about, it is a little messy around here. We've got a couple of work days coming up next Saturday, or Saturday, the next two Saturdays. So we look forward to all the work that's going to get done there as well. And we also we want to thank you very much for last week. You guys were very generous at our mission trip, Guatemala mission trip fundraiser meal over here. We want to thank you for your generosity there and helping out the youth and the adults that are going to be going on that mission trip. And we also have a nice thank you, or a nice email here from one of our missionaries there, from Juliet and Roger Morris in Abidjan, Ivory Coast. And they're also wanting to, so they're saying Happy Easter to you and your families. And they have a nice little note there as we also remember them on this day as they celebrate the Resurrection Day as well. Now Derek's going to have an announcement.
If I could have Dave come forward. I visited with Dave Klee a couple of weeks ago, and he's been coming with family, and so glad to have him since January to come over. And Dave is an immersed believer in Christ and wanted to get back in church, and so we've been privileged to have him part of our church family for the last 3 or 4 months, and so just so glad. And he wanted to place his membership today, so just going to have him state the good confession. And Dave, if you could say after me here, we'll get it on the... I believe that Jesus is the Christ.
That Jesus is the Christ.
The Son of the living God.
The Son of the living God.
And I choose to follow him.
And I choose to follow him.
As my Lord and Savior.
As my Lord and Savior.
So thankful on Easter. I can't think of a better day to make a decision and to commit to Christ. So let's clap for Dave here. Let me pray. God, we thank you for the resurrection of Jesus. It gives us life, and I thank you for Dave and his faith in you. And we pray that he would honor you, and just that we could hold each other accountable as we follow Jesus and serve him and give God glory. We pray your blessing on Dave and his family, that you'd watch over him and welcome him to our church. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Dave.
You're welcome. Amen to that. If you all would, let's stand together, and we're going to sing some songs of praise and worship and celebration, all because of Easter Sunday, the day that our Lord Jesus Christ rose from that grave. Christ the Lord is risen today. day. Amen to that? That's what this whole song was about. And because of that, he lives. And that's what this one is, because he lives.
Call him Jesus. He
the living. Adam's going to lead us in this next song that just basically kind of gives us a whole overview of this past week of Holy Week, from what's all transpired to today. So sing along with this. If you don't know it, at least get the message from it, because it's a great song, it's a great message.
That once was crowned with thorns is crowned with glory now. The Savior now to wash our feet, now at his feet we bow. The one who wore shines for all to see. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Your name is victory. Your praise
that held us now gives way to him who is our peace. His final breath upon the cross is now alive in me. Ashes of defeat, the resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. Resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive to declare your victory. The resurrected King is resurrecting me. By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes of defeat. Resurrecting me.
where soldiers march. As we look back upon the resurrection of your son Christ, he is the one who gives us hope for a new life. And then, Lord, you have sent your spirit to live in us, to help us live that new life in Christ, to honor and to obey your word. So, Lord, as we hear the word brought this morning to us, and as we partake with communion, Lord, help us to engage our mind, our spirit, and may it be one with your spirit. Lord, lead and guide and direct us. We thank you for the resurrection. We thank you for salvation found only in Christ. For it's in his name that we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
As we get ready for communion this morning, we're also going to kind of combine a little short little children's moment here. So if any children, fifth grade and younger, if you'd like to come up here and stand up here on these stage pieces, but be very careful. Don't lean against the wall. Lesson learned from first service. Is that wise to have someone with a broken arm on the top? All right, we got a few more coming. Well, now don't you guys all look nice? You guys feel good today? Yeah? No, okay. Well, I think you guys all look great. So we're going to just real quick here, we're going to think about communion. But before this, how would you guys like it if we served this for communion each week. Anybody think that would be pretty good if I just said this there? No? 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 How many of you guys think we should just switch the communion bread and put those in your Easter eggs today when you go hunting them? Or would you rather have some chocolate in your Easter eggs? Huh? You're okay with switching it, okay? The communion bread? Okay. Well, remember that. He's happy with communion bread. Now, I think we'd be a little disappointed there. We like to go hunting for these Easter eggs and enjoy the candy that we get at Easter. But we all know that it's not about the Easter candy, is it? No? No? Anybody know what it's about, why we celebrate Easter?
The resurrection.
The resurrection. All right. You guys agree with that? The resurrection. Okay. Resurrection. Just what resurrection?
The resurrection of Jesus Christ.
The resurrection of Jesus Christ. Okay. All right. We celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ today. And anybody have a favorite candy bar? Huh? Anyone? Yeah, you got a favorite? What's your favorite?
Twix
is your favorite. What's your favorite candy bar? Snickers. Oh, he's saying Snickers here. You know, I have a lot. I mean, it's hard for me to pick a favorite candy bar. But there is one that I think every year when my kids, when they do go, they may not know this, but after they get their candy and they bring it back and sitting around and whenever you guys are away from your candy, parents like to go to your Easter baskets and find the candy that they like. And the one that I like to find a lot that I eat pretty quick is the Twix, okay? Because it's a little different than the other. It's because it's actually a cookie with all the good stuff wrapped around it, okay? That's pretty unique. And there's a lot of people that chase after a lot of different things. There's a lot of false gods. But we know that we have the most unique Savior because he's the only one that rose from the grave, okay? Others may proclaim to be a god, but we have the one true God, and he rose from the grave. And so we think about that this morning as we celebrate Easter, and I hope you enjoyed this. But I'm going to, real quick, last service I was going to have you guys do it. This, I think, today I'm going to have it real quick here. Did anybody remember, the adults, you guys remember sword races? Or sword drills? Not races, sword drills? Vacation Bible school, Sunday school? Okay, there's a couple. Could I have two volunteer to come up and do a sword drill? Show these kids what a sword drill is. You know what a sword drill? Hold on. I want to see if these adults can do it. Anybody want to come on up? Volunteer? Anyone? I'll even tell you the book that it's going to... All right, well, I'll use a couple kids here then. If you okay, no, oh, they're like no. Any kids up here want to do it? Can you find it though? Are you gonna be for sure to find it? Hey, there's a volunteer. Is this a volunteer? Sure. Is that a volunteer? Okay, come on up, ladies. Sword drills? Sword drill. Okay, Sue. You don't want to do it? Okay. Pick a challenger. Okay.
All right. We'll let you stand right out here.
Is there
someone
for second place?
Put them on your heads. And the scripture.
Okay, hold them up. Hold them up above your heads. I'll tell you the scripture. Okay. Okay, above your head. And we're going to, okay, I'm going to tell you, it's going to be Isaiah 53:5. Isaiah 53:5. Go. And once you find it, just...
What is with the print on
this? It's very tiny print. Isaiah 53:5. Just give Lindsay a candy bar for that?
Yeah!
Okay.
Yeah.
Lindsay?
Oh, which one, Lindsay?
Oh. The Snickers.
All right. Okay. So, is it fair to just give Lindsay one? No. You guys, are you guys thinking you want some of these? Okay. Well, let me go first. Before we do this, we want to think, since it's not all about candy, I want to go through that verse real quick here with you guys. I'm gonna read it one more time here. And then after the service is over, I'll have this candy sitting out there, and you guys can all have a piece of that candy, take a piece of candy home. But that verse says, but he was pierced, Isaiah 53:5, but he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. So that big word transgressions there that we talk about, you know, that's basically our rebellion, our sin, our rebellion from God, and he was pierced. He was put up on a cross, and he was before that he was beaten, he was whipped, had a crown of thorns on his head, and he was put on the cross. So he went through an awful lot because of our rebellion, because of our sin. And it talks about iniquities. That's basically breaking, you know, us breaking God's laws. And then it says that at the end there, it says we are healed. When it talks about being healed, that means we are basically, you know, free from sin. God looks at us differently now because of what Jesus has done for us on the cross. And that's what we come through. We come to this table each and every week at communion, and we think about that. We think about what Jesus has done for us on the cross. And we give him thanks, and we celebrate his victory over death. And so I want to think about that as we come around for communion this morning. And I'm going to pray, and then I'm going to let you guys go back to your seat and make sure you take one of these, because, you know, this gift here that I'm giving you, it's only good if you come and take it yourself. You come and accept this gift that I'm giving you. If you don't, you're out of, okay? You're just at a loss there. But we want to know that everybody here deserves this gift here because of what Jesus has done for us. So let's pray. God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for what you have done for us on the cross, and that you have defeated sin and death, and that we are free, we are healed because of that. And God, I just thank you so much for these kids. I pray that they would always continue to grow in you and remember what this day is all about, and just give you thanks this day. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, guys. You're going to have a seat. Remember to get this as you leave.
We especially want to thank Nathan, the music team, and the choir for their great job. So let's give them a hand. They spent a whole lot of hours, and a few weeks ago we planned out all the times, and one of the practice times happened to be yesterday at 5 o'clock, and there was a certain game that was happening. And while they were practicing, the Illini were playing great basketball. When they stopped singing, the Illini stopped playing. So I just want to let you know that there was something going on there. But we sometimes use this phrase, happy holidays, and we think of Christmas or we think of Thanksgiving. We don't necessarily tag it to Easter when we say happy holidays, but what the word means is happy holy day. That this is a holy day, and more biblically, we would say happy resurrection day. That this is all about the resurrection of Jesus Christ, and our culture has forgotten that. Maybe you saw the headline where the White House has said no symbols on the Easter eggs this year, that we're just doing all generic, so no religious symbols. And we would disagree. We would say you can't celebrate Easter without symbols. Particular, I've got a picture of a few eggs here. If we're talking about symbols, it's always the cross. It's always the empty tomb. Without that, Easter, well, it's just a fun day, but it means nothing without the cross and without the empty tomb. This is what it's about. So this golden cross, what we talk about today, the gospel in the next picture, that this is the center of the Christian faith, the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, it means everything. I was visiting in the nursing home in Pena this past week, and on Thursday I was visiting with Janice, and she, as many of you know, is struggling with dementia, and she was in her wheelchair, and I said, Janice, this week we get to celebrate Easter and the resurrection. And she immediately, without blinking an eye, she said, it's not just the resurrection of Jesus, it's our resurrection, it's my resurrection too. And she understands the importance of Easter. As her life winds down, as she goes through struggles, she realizes all the Easter she's celebrated, it's not just Jesus, it's because of Jesus we get to resurrect as well. The most important verse maybe on the resurrection outside the Gospels is this one in 1 Corinthians 15. And it says this phrase, what I received, I passed on you as first importance, most important. This is the most important thing that you can know about the Christian faith, that Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. And so this is more than just a holiday, it is a holy day. It is all about Jesus Christ. In fact, in 1 Corinthians 15, we learn that Jesus would appear, and he would appear to the disciples. He would appear to 500 people all at once, that Jesus in this appearance, sometimes we think, I think we naively think that when Jesus rose from the dead, that he appeared once and that was it. Maybe someone saw him. No, it's much more than that. There's a reason the robust theology that we have in the Christian faith is that Jesus Christ appeared to all the disciples who are willing to give their lives, suffer for the cause of Christ, 500 people, and it wasn't just one day. Jesus appeared for over 40 days. Different circumstances, he appeared but before he ascended into heaven. We believe this is the most important event, the resurrection and Jesus Christ appearing in bodily form. So this is so important. When I asked Brother Lynn over a year ago what scripture he wanted used for his funeral, he said 1 Corinthians 15. We know this is so important because it is the resurrection of Jesus Christ. There's no chapter, again, outside the Gospels like this one. 1 Corinthians 15, 17 through 19 says, and if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile. You're still in your sins. Then those also who have fallen asleep in Christ are lost. If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we of all people are to be pitied. What a passage to dwell on. That we should all be home right now eating chocolate bunnies, not here at church. We could be mowing our lawn, a lot of things if Christ has not been raised. Obviously, Paul doesn't finish the passage this way. 1 Corinthians 15:20, but Christ has indeed been raised from the dead.
He's the first fruit. He's the one. He's the first. He's the greatest one. He's the one. Because Christ has done it first, it means through his power, we also can be resurrected. And I hope that you understand how important this is, that if you believe this today, if you confess this today, that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you believe in the resurrection, you repent of your sins, and you confess Christ as Lord, then this should change you, your priorities, and how you live. It should change everything about us because we now believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. And so do you believe this? And not just say it, not just come today, but do you believe this? This decision is the most important that you will ever make in your life to proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord. I believe he died, was buried, and rose again, and I want to make him Lord. We've been working in our Welcome Center, as you can tell, in case you thought we should have at least cleaned up a little bit better before Easter. But we've been working on picking out the carpet, and we've had someone who's pretty stylish, maybe has more of a feminine side. And so Josh has been working on picking out the carpet, and he's, sorry, I didn't say that the first time, but he's, we've come down to two selections. So I thought, I don't know if Easter Sunday is the best day to do this, but here's the picture of our selections. Josh has narrowed it down to one of these two, and I thought, why not just vote on it on Easter morning, and we'll know. And maybe some of you walk in to church and you're saying, you know what, I just don't feel with it, I'm not fully awake, or I'm having a hard time. This carpet will help you. So that's what we're after. So how many are going to say on the left? How many vote on the left? Okay. And then how many on the right? All right. Isn't that colorful and pretty? So we should at least do Josh's office and this carpet here. So here's what the good news is, though. It really doesn't matter on carpet. You're thinking, no, that would matter. But on Easter, Paul says, your carpet, your other decisions, painting the walls, it doesn't, that's not what's most important. And so here's our phrase we want. This is what is most important at the Tower Hill Christian Church, is that we preach the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus and put our faith in Jesus as Lord and Savior. Amen? There's something more important than all these other side issues, side items that a church can get involved in, that a church that is going to believe in the Bible and follow God, we believe the death, burial, and resurrection, the bodily resurrection of Christ. This is the good news, what we call the gospel. This gospel, good news, Jesus saves, that is what we are after, and that is what Paul proclaims in 1 Corinthians 15. So, just a brief message today, if we can remind you all of that. Wow, this is important. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 15, don't forget, I want to remind you of the gospel. If you can remember anything on this Easter, Resurrection Sunday, be reminded of the gospel. It is the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus. For this, we take our stand. We take hold of it. Don't let go. And I tell you this, don't forget it. Sometimes we give reminders. It's easy to forget things. You know, I'll never forget. Well, we know this is easier said than done. We know the distractions in this world and the challenges. A few years ago, I ran across this picture, and it is people playing golf in the big island in Hawaii. And May 15, 2018 is what this is from. In fact, a few days later, they closed down all the golf courses because the ash and everything was getting a little bit out of control. But apparently, these golfers did not think it was that bad. And so I don't know if you would feel comfortable playing a game of golf here, but this would scare me just a little bit. It's a real picture. It also is a real picture of society that says, full speed ahead, enjoy this life, get what you can out of it, don't think about the consequences. Don't think about the big things going on, just pretend everything is fine. And today on this Easter, it's easy for us to pretend, it's easy for us to be in denial about reality, but I tell you that there are real issues and there's real problems. In fact, when we look at Friday and Jesus on the cross, Jesus died on the cross. His blood was shed, not because everything is just fine. And this picture, as you look at Jesus and you think about his suffering, it wasn't just so, hey, happy Easter, we'll create a holiday. Won't it be great? We'll get together. We'll have all kinds of fun. No, it's you're dead in your sin. There's judgment. And if you don't accept the sacrifice of Christ, you're lost in your sin. And so we accept Jesus and his death and his burial and his resurrection. He didn't die just because nothing serious is going on. He didn't die because it's no big deal. He died like this because it's a really big deal that our eternal destiny, what we think about Christ matters. And so we put our faith in the one who died and has risen from the dead. Things are not fine and dandy. We need the sacrifice of Jesus. So 1 Corinthians 15 says, I remind you of the gospel. By this gospel you are so saved. Hold firmly. Hang on to this. Don't just celebrate Easter, not think deeply about your life. Hold firmly to this good news. Last week, we all saw the news where six bridge workers in Baltimore died suddenly, and they died unexpectedly. Who would have thought, they didn't think, that there would be a ship that would collide with the pillars holding up the bridge, and yet in just a moment, an instant, that they're gone. And I wonder if we need to reflect a little deeper today how quickly we have this life and how quickly we could lose it. And so we trust in the Lord Jesus Christ as our only hope. Most of you know my sweet mother passed away last week on Palm Sunday. And I appreciate everyone showing such love to my mother. She's lived with us in this area now, over in Shelbyville and Pena for 4.5 years, and been in memory care for a year now. And so we'll have her services in Oklahoma later this week. But as you all do when you lose someone you love, you kind of go through a lot of pictures. And so I've been looking through pictures, and I found some that stood out that I don't think I've seen before. And I found this one of Mom with some hair, crazy hair. So this is her on the left, and this is her friend Georgia on the right. But I don't know from the 60s and 70s if anyone wants to bring this hairstyle back, but... that's interesting. The other one I found is a family. We don't have too many family pictures, but this is one of my few family pictures. And some of you saw this 6 years ago, but if you want to know the epitome of a dysfunctional family, it is when your one good family picture you have, your brother is wearing sweats and a see-through netted shirt. And we're not even sure. He may have worn this to my grandfather's funeral. So it's right after my grandfather's funeral. But normal parents would say, you know what, son, why don't you change this? Let's find something else. Because we're all dressed up, and you're wearing a netted see-through shirt for your family picture. So my last one is this precious, I hadn't seen this picture before, and this is Mom's favorite son at age 2. And so isn't he cute? But but this is my precious mother. And my mother, you should know, is the first person to ever share the good news, the gospel, with me. She's the first person to ever read the Bible story about Jesus to me. She is the one who has supported me in ministry like no other. She's the one that took me to church my whole childhood. This is my mother. And like Janice, she says, hey, it's not just Jesus has risen from the dead. Because Jesus has risen from the dead, even when we die, we live. Easter, Resurrection Sunday, it's about Christ and it's about us, that through his power of resurrection, we could have life. So 1 Corinthians 15, it says this. Hey, can I tell you what's most important? There's something more important than anything else. It's that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, and that he raised on the third day according to the scriptures. If you believe this and you proclaim Christ as Lord and Savior, you're good. The resurrection of Christ is not to create a holiday. It's to create a holy day that offers us salvation. And so I hope as you go away today, you realize how significant the cross is, the empty tomb is, why this matters. At the very end of 1 Corinthians 15, right before the last verse, we find this phrase, But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. And today, I hope you've found that victory. I hope that this is not just a holiday for you, but this means more, that even in death, you could have life. That the one who has died for our sin, who has paid the penalty for our sin, that by his resurrection, we have victory. And so I hope that's true for you. And if you have not ever made a decision, the choir is going to come one final song, and then we'll let you go celebrate with your family. But if you've not ever made a decision to follow Christ, we invite you during this song. Also invite you to talk with me afterwards. We want to talk deeper as we look at Scripture, that only through Christ do we have this victory. Let's pray. God, we thank you for a great day. We thank you for sunshine. We thank you for everyone being here. And we can fellowship and laugh, and yet we realize that this is so important. That is the most important thing that we will ever make in our life in deciding to follow Jesus Christ as Lord. Through him, only he can conquer death and give us eternal life. He's the only one who can pay the sacrifice, the penalty for our sin, so that we can have life and forgiveness. We thank you for this redemption story. We thank you for giving us hope on this Resurrection Sunday. And God, I pray that if there's anyone who has never put their faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, that your spirit would convict and that you would lead and guide them, God, that they would follow Jesus as Lord and Savior. God, we give you all the glory. We thank you for the victory we have in Jesus. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Well, we're going to close out with a song that is a song of celebration. And it's a song that I'm sure that probably 98% of you know. But I'm going to need your help. So if you all would, let's stand together. And you may not have sung it this way very often. I'll just put it that way. Okay? But I need your help. So you're going to clap with me, okay? On the beat, Eric. On the beat. All right? Here we go. One, two.
Save. Yeah.